It is Tuesday night, January 9th, 2018, coming at you from Wichita, Kansas. You guys already know where I'm going. The best card room in the state, the Kansas Star Casino. Two games going right now, just put my name on the list. Hopefully play 6 or 7 hours maybe. Get back to Pratt about 6 in the morning, I'd say. Not gonna play tomorrow because I gotta watch Odie while my wife goes and plays volleyball. And then I'll get in a few sessions on Thursday, Friday, Saturday. I need to do some clarification on the 60K bankroll building challenge this year. So the stipulations are, the only way to build this roll up to 60,000 is through 1-3 no limit hold'em and below. This does not include pot limit Omaha. This does not include 2-5, which I play occasionally if I go somewhere else. The two primary places that I play is at the Kansas Star Casino and another game in town, which is a 1-2 game. $60,000 bankroll challenge. Let's go. I'm not that kind of guy. It's not a revolution. This ain't no illusion. Gotta do a plug for one of the greatest songs ever created. When my family and I went and saw Kansas live at the Fox Theater in Hutch a year or two ago, I had never heard this song before, and when I heard it live, it was one of the best songs that I've ever heard. I'm gonna play a little driving montage where you get a little clip of this song. It's called Miracles Out of Nowhere by Kansas, and it is the best. From the Star, I talked about a hand, but the quality of the video was terrible. I'm actually going to give you guys what the villain in this hand was experiencing, and so I'm going to show you what their cards were, and I'm not going to tell you what my cards were until the end. So under the gun limps, I decide to limp after him with 8-9 of clubs. Everybody else limps along, and some loose aggressive aggro tard in the small blind bumps it up to $26. The under the gun player calls. My hand's pretty enough, I decide to call. The flop comes King of Hearts, 10 of Hearts, 7 of Diamonds. The small blind checks, which is odd, because he's a super aggressive player. The under the gun player checks. I'm open-ended, so I go ahead and decide I'm gonna put out a small $25 bet. And then there he is. That long-haired kid that always wears camo puts in a raise to $85. The under the gun player folds. I'm open-ended, I call. The turn is an 8 of hearts, and the small blind just rips it all in there. Almost $200. I sit there and think for a super long time.
1 eternity later.
And then he picks up his cards and shows me the 9 of hearts. I read that boy for weakness. I stick my whole stack in. The river's a deuce. I table my hand and we win. So, obviously that one didn't work out.
The flop is ace, ace. Trey Munns hits the jackpot with trips. Blum comes up empty and checks. Munns, that's 9,000.
I thought Munns might check there and hope that Blum bluffs at it on the turn.
No, but he'll bluff at it here. A check raise bluff to 58,000.
Blum, you said, is 18?
Yeah.
I'm not sure he's going to make it to 19.
Not with plays like that. And now Munns with a re-raise of his own to 116,000.
Munns rebuffs Blum's bluff.
Blum goes all in.
It's a brave new world out there, Lon.
Okay, cool.
He does call.
Oops.
And shows the ace. Oh, and
she had plenty of cojones to make that call, so props to her. Made for an interesting story. She ended up having a great night, so. One for the bad guys. It's all right. Running a nice bluff. It's humbling, but you can only get better. Elected not to drive to the star tonight because of this. So, we're multi-tabling 1-2 PLO on global poker. I'll let you guys sweat. Now it's time for me to enter this icy tundra.
Poker room, this is Curtis. How may I help you?
Hey Curtis, can you put Devin on the 1-3 no limit list and then on the 1-2 PLO list?
Yep.
Thanks, man.
You bet. We'll see you in a little bit.
Bye.
6.5 hours later.
Tonight was the worst night that I have ever had. I couldn't get anything going. None of my bluffs went through, none of my value hands held up. Oh, don't feel good about it. Pretty nasty. Trying to keep the vlog as real as possible after the worst night I've ever had in my life. Matt decided that we're gonna grab some breakfast here at the IHOP.
Well, we both got omelets. I got a side of pancakes to go with mine. Matt got a side of fruit. That's sad.
Later.
Holy cow, we got him tonight. Just kidding, we got him for okay. We did all right. We made a very weird number. It's a very casino-esque number. We made $777. I don't know what this means, guys. Could be the beginning to a great month after a slippery slope this first. After a slippery slope here at the beginning. Just gonna grab my breakfast here. Oh, what's that? Oh, that's a citation. So yeah, on the way home from the star, just like clockwork, the law enforcement around these parts are harassing me. Same police officers pulled me over 3 times. First time, I got a fix-it ticket to fix my window tint in my car, which I didn't even know was illegal. Second time, I got a speeding ticket, and today,
I thankfully got a warning. Cody, sit. Is this for the people?
Good boy.
Shake.
Good boy! Good boy!
So I was in the middle of explaining a hand that happened from the night before. It was a hand that Matt played, the guy that I went to IHOP with that night. I may get certain parts of this hand incorrect, but I think this is how it went down. The under the gun player opens to $25. A couple people call, it folds around to Matt, who is in the big blind with pocket kings. Matt three bets to $100. The under the gun player four bets to $500. They are 1500 effect, 1600 effective during this hand. Matt goes ahead and decides to call the $500. The flop comes 2-3-4 rainbow. Matt checks. And the under the gun player bets $1,000. I mean, that is just a super crazy bluff. He has a bluff here. You have to ask yourself, is he ever doing this with queens? Is he ever betting 500 before the flop with queens? It's unlikely he has ace king because Matt blocks two kings. I probably fold.
I used to go on there and tell some of the regulars, I was like, you nitty mother.
In this spot, I have a preconceived image of this player as a super tight, solid player. Matt finds a call with the pocket kings, and the villain shows ace-eight of diamonds. Drawn pretty thin on that hand. Pocket kings hold, and Matt goes on to have a $4,000 night playing 2-5 at the Kansas Star. Okay, so I got an interesting one. I am on the button with pocket kings. There is one limp in middle position. I raised $18 on the button. We are 600 effective in this hand. The small blind calls, the big blind calls, which is a super solid reg. And then the middle position player actually plays for a living up in Kansas City. And he's very good as well, but he is way more on the tight side than the other villain in the hand. The flop comes queen 3-5 rainbow. Small blind checks, the big blind checks, the middle position player checks. I put out a sizable bet here. I know it's a very dry board, but somebody has a queen, they're calling. If not, they're probably folding. I go to $60. The big blind player calls and the middle position player calls. The turn is a six of diamonds, which brings in a backdoor flush draw. The small blind checks, the middle position player moves all in for 150. And this is really the only interesting spot of the hand. I feel like I should probably fold here.
I used to go on there and tell some of the regulars, I was like, you nitty mother.
Against most opponents, this is a pretty easy call, but against this one, it's very player dependent. I believe it's a fold in most circumstances against this player, but in the long run against most players, I'll be calling this. So I decide to go with the call, and the small blind or the big blind also calls. The river is an ace of diamonds, and the big blind ships it, which is an easy fold for me as we're not beating anything now. The big blind actually had 5-7 of diamonds, so he rivered a flush, and the middle position player had 5-6. And he had turned two pair, so probably should have folded on the turn, but I don't know. Mental coin flip. Let me know down in the comments what you guys do on the turn facing that $150 bet. Are you guys raising? Are you guys folding? Are you guys just calling? Tough spot. So I haven't been playing as much 1-3 as I'd like for this 60K challenge. So left myself a little note here on our whiteboard in our house to remind myself every day No more 2-5 or PLO. Only 1-3 and 1-2. No limit hold'em. Just gotta follow that rule. And that is the end of this week's vlog.